I did feel that we were going to be very good defensively. We made a couple of moves that that I knew were going to make us real tough defensively. The key I felt, now we're going back to August, the key I felt would be that we stay healthy. And I wasn't sure we would have a lot of depth, and I felt we had to have people jump up in certain positions. Now that happened. We had people jump in there. You take a David Myslinski who jumped in at center and did a very good job, and Todd Amick, that we moved him from fullback and linebacker to the line. Some moves like that that really paid off for us, and we did stay healthy.
At the beginning of the 1992 high school football season, when discussion centered on who would be the best team in the WPIAL's Quad A in 1992, you would hear schools such as Butler, Connellsville, North Allegheny, North Hills, Mount Lebanon, Penn Hills, and of course, Upper St. Clair mentioned as possibilities. But there was no doubt about it, by the end of November, all discussions concerning Whipple's Quad A football started and stopped with the Panthers. In 1992, Upper St. Clair again rose to the top of the WPIAL, going undefeated in the regular season, and then captured three straight Whipple playoff games to win its third WPIAL championship in 5 years. In doing so, the Panthers proved they are part of what is undisputedly the finest program in Western Pennsylvania. While Upper St. Clair is expected to challenge for the title every year, the pressure doesn't seem to faze any Panther player. Many teams would be burdened with the label of contender. The 1992 Panthers simply proved they deserved that distinction and reveled in the glory. Since 1988, Upper St. Clair has dominated Quad A football in the WPIAL. The Panthers have compiled an incomparable 59-7-1 record. Head coach Jim Render, his assistant coaches, and the players can take all the credit. In 1992, the Panthers became champions again. They captured their fourth straight Quad West Conference championship with a regular season ending 31-12 victory over arch rival Mount Lebanon. And then the WPIAL Quad A crown with a 10-7 victory over North Allegheny at Three River Stadium. It was Upper St. Clair's fourth trip to the championship game in 5 years. And while Upper St. Clair fell short of a second state championship in 4 years, 1992 was certainly a year of which to be proud. the 14-1 record, WPIAL championship, and outstanding individual and team efforts made it a season in which the Panthers continued a tradition of greatness. When you talk Upper St. Clair football, you must talk about defense. And through the first half of the 1992 season, the Panther defense simply overpowered the opposition. Led by Associated Press Big School All-State first-team lineman Mark Hondru, Upper St. Clair posted four shutouts in its first five games. The Panthers overwhelmed their early season opponents, scoring 173 points to the opponent's six. Upper St. Clair opened the season with a 50-0 shellacking of Chartiers Valley and followed that with a Quad West Conference opening 50-6 victory over Uniontown. The Panthers stepped out of the conference in week three and handed Hempfield a 21-0 beating. In week four, Upper St. Clair was anticipating its first big challenge of the season at Ringgold. The Rams nearly surprised Mount Lebanon earlier in the season, building a 16-0 lead before losing 19-16. But the Panthers were ready, and the defense buried Ringgold. USC held the Rams to one first down and 62 yards. The Panthers forced two fumbles and intercepted a pass. While the Panther defense stifled Ringgold, the offense ran away from the Rams. Alan Hamrick gained 88 yards on 13 carries. Zach Ellis and Todd Amick scored on runs. Billy Price added a field goal, and USC rolled up 224 yards en route to the win. The Panthers closed out the first half of the regular season with a 28-0 decision over Trinity. The Hillers managed just 128 yards, and USC unleashed its arsenal of runners as Hammer gained 115 yards on six carries and scored on a 71-yard run. Amick and Darren Martin each scored on four-yard runs. And J.T. Render reached the end zone on an 8-yard run. At 5-0, the Panthers had lived up to their preseason billing as one of the best teams in Quad A. Over the next 8 weeks, they would prove it.
Winner. I've been here before, yo, I ain't no beginner. Word. But I've been new, tried and true. Survival of the finish, yo, it brought me through. My crew talk, we're ready to strike. Train for the mission, so believe the hype. And sweat it, sweat it, cause you're gonna regret it. The day that you dissed us, you wish you never met us. You remind me of a real short story. One hit record and you start recording. Get ready, cause this is it. Your crew is through, and we too legit to quit slaying.
The road to the Quad West Conference title runs through Upper St. Clair. The Baldwin Fighting Highlanders certainly know all about that. In week six, the teams collided in a battle that would go a long way in deciding the championship and one of the two playoff spots in the conference. The Panthers were just too much. USC's defense yielded its first points of the season when the Fighting Highlanders drove 62 yards in their first possession to take a 7-0 lead. But the Panthers came roaring back. They tied the game early in the second quarter when Ellis ran 27 yards for a touchdown. It was just one of many bright moments for Ellis in the game as he rushed for 158 yards on 18 carries. An interception with 1 minute and 1 second left in the first half thwarted a Baldwin scoring attempt and set up a Panther score. USC drove to the Fighting Highlanders 16 before Price booted a 33-yard field goal to give the Panthers a 10-7 advantage. The Panthers took control in the second half as Ellis scored again on a 12-yard run and Ross Alessandro on a 24-yard carry. Baldwin returned the ensuing kickoff for a score and threatened late in the game, but USC's defense stood tall and stopped the Fighting Highlanders on downs to wrap up win number 6. USC registered shutouts in its next two games, slipping by Bethel Park 7-0 and blasting Cannon McMillan 38-0. The winning formula in both games was a punishing running game and superior defense. The defense was so overpowering against the Blackhawks that Render said, quote, "If we would have played for 2 more hours, our defense wasn't going to give up a point," end of quote. That defense led the charge against the Big Macs as well. Cannon McMillan gained just 34 yards rushing, while the Panthers pounded out 282 yards. Hamrick led the way, gaining 145 yards on 8 carries. Ellis added 74 yards on 10 carries. USC blew the game open in the third quarter. Leading 14-0, the Panthers got a 70-yard punt return for a touchdown from Ellis. Moments later, Alessandro broke through and blocked a punt. That set up a 5-yard pass from quarterback Mike Tomko to Ryan Smith. Amick added a short touchdown run, and Price kicked a 32-yard field goal. In Week 9, the Panthers struck early and often. USC exploded for 21 points in 8 minutes and 43 seconds and then cruised to a 41-6 victory over Laurel Highlands. Hamrick scored on runs of 2, 45, and 35 yards, and Rick West reached the end zone on a 63-yard run. Amick scored on a 5-yard run, and Tomko and Hamrick combined on a 40-yard touchdown pass to give the Panthers their final score of the game. The win set up the showdown for the conference championship with Mount Lebanon.
Machines sprung from cages on highway
about saving the best for last. That's exactly what Upper St. Clair did in the regular season title-clinching finale against the Blue Devils. The Panthers proved they were the best in the West on this night. From start to finish, Upper St. Clair manhandled Mount Lebanon, and you can be sure every one of the Panthers loved it. In capturing a convincing 31-12 win, USC pounded Lebo. Hamrick rushed for 132 yards on 16 carries, and he established himself and the Panthers quite early. Hamrick gained 40 yards on USC's opening series and scored on a 23-yard run to cap the 63-yard drive. Just minutes later, Mark Rutledge intercepted a Matt Kramer pass and returned the ball to the Mount Lebanon 14. Two plays later, Ellis scored on an 8-yard run, and the rout was on. After the Blue Devils cut the lead to 14-6 with a second quarter touchdown, the Panthers rose again. USC drove 69 yards, and Alessandro scored on a 22-yard run to give the Panthers a 15-point halftime lead. They put the game away in the third quarter when Ellis scored on a 33-yard run. Mount Lebanon managed another touchdown, but Price added the final points of the game with a 43-yard field goal in the fourth quarter. At 10-0, no one could now have any doubt just who was the best in the Quad West or who was the favorite to win the WPIAL title. To the start of the playoffs, Render warned against any title talk. Said the veteran coach, quote, "There are a lot of strong teams in the WPIAL. I don't think there are any easy roads to Three River Stadium. If you're looking for an easy way there, you are in the wrong tournament," end of quote. Render's words were prophetic indeed. The WPIAL playoffs were anything but easy for Upper St. Clair. But the tournament did prove to be the right one for the Panthers. USC's quarterfinal opponent, Woodland Hills, looked to be totally outmanned. The Wolverines limped into the playoffs with a 4-6 record. But they played the Panthers tough. Woodland Hills drove to USC's 3-yard line on the opening series of the game. But Martin, a linebacker, and Rutledge, a cornerback, combined to stop the Wolverines on fourth down. Linebacker Joe Romano also made a big play when he caused a 4-yard loss on a first down play near the goal line. The Panthers managed their only score of the first half with 2 minutes and 20 seconds left to play when Ellis ran 7 yards. USC took command in the third quarter. Chris McIntyre intercepted a Woodland Hills pass. Tomko then hit Romano with a pass that went for 10 yards on a touchdown. Hamrick added the final TD in the fourth quarter on a 1-yard dive. A date in the semifinals against their friends from Butler awaited the Panthers. While the first 45 minutes of that game won't hold many memories, the final 2.5 minutes will be etched in Upper St. Clair football lore. Trailing 3-0, the Panthers took over at Butler's 37-yard line. Tomko opened the drive with completions of 13 yards to Rutledge and 15 yards to David Mandler. Ellis then ran right and reached the end zone for a 9-yard touchdown with 1 minute and 47 seconds remaining. The USC defense, which limited the Golden Tornadoes to 144 yards and 8 first downs, did the rest as the Panthers earned their spot in the WPIAL championship game against North Allegheny. Under the bright lights at Three Rivers and in front of KBL cameras, the Panthers shined brightly. After a scoreless first quarter, USC went on a 14-play drive that used 7 minutes of the clock to gain the lead. Price's 22-yard field goal capped the 81-yard drive. Hamrick and Ellis pounded at the Tigers' defense, but it was a 6-yard run by Tomko on a 4th-and-2 play from North Allegheny's 30 that keyed the drive. The Panther defense dominated, holding the Tigers to just 39 yards and 1 first down in the first half. Hamrick then stunned N.A. and the crowd with a 69-yard touchdown run to open the third quarter. The 10 points would be enough, as North Allegheny could manage only 1 touchdown. The championship sparked a wild celebration as the Panthers and their loyal fans cherished another championship. There were some familiar faces and sounds in the champions' locker room. It was just a part of a very special night that saw Upper St. Clair add to a tradition of greatness.
When all I've done, all of the dreaming, scheming, and screaming becomes one, this is the day. Just I've lived for becomes mine. This is the moment, this is the hour, when I can open up tomorrow like a flower and put my hand to everything I plan to fulfill my grand design, see all my stars align.
With the WPIAL championship trophy in hand, the Panthers set out to get the PIAA trophy. In 1989, Upper St. Clair became the only team in Whitfield history to finish the season with a 15-0 record and state championship. These Panthers were trying to duplicate that feat. In the state semifinals, State College shocked USC with 13 quick points. But this time, it was the Panthers' offense that would carry the day, and State College simply had no chance. USC rolled up 399 yards of total offense and scored three touchdowns of 25 yards or more as the Panthers blew away State College 42-13. The big play of the game came when Ellis returned a punt 46 yards for a touchdown. Hamrick scored three touchdowns and gained 178 yards. Ellis and Alessandro added second-half touchdown runs. A heavy snowfall across the state forced the postponement of the championship game for a week. It just might have stalled the USC Express as well. When the Panthers finally met undefeated Cumberland Valley at Altoona's Mansion Park on Saturday, December 19th, everything seemed a little bit out of sync. USC could not stop Cumberland Valley's All-America running back John Ritchie, and the Panthers fell 28-12. Ritchie rushed for 177 yards and two touchdowns and caught three passes for 23 yards. He was just too much, the best player a Jim Render-led USC team ever faced. The Panthers did manage 324 yards of offense, but penalties and turnovers denied them any chance of staying up with the Eagles. The loss in the state title game could in no way diminish the many accomplishments of the season. It was a great year.
Yo, what's up, Mark? Break it down. Got a notice, doubt in your output account. Running rough, rise, he's been paid in large amounts.
prepared, so you gotta believe.
A season that saw so many seniors contribute so much. It is those players that have helped maintain the standard of excellence that is known as Upper St. Clair football. Their efforts are certain to help many more in the years to come.
Your way, so I'll go, but I know I'll think of you every step of the way. And don't cry, we both